Hello, everybody. It is 5:30. My apologies. It is 5:30, and it is time for Subdiagonal from B3, Killing Harmony. We just started the fourth trial. Well, we were about to start the fourth trial. The victim is new and remodeled the Ultimate Inventor. We're not sure how she was killed, and the game refused to let us look at her eyes in order to tell if she was poisoned or not. So we don't really have any good suspect. We kind of have some sort of a suspect. Kaito was sort of forcefully logged out before everyone else was, but that was due to some cell phone, and you could log out by just saying someone's name. It doesn't have to be the person saying their own name. So we're not really sure what everything could lead to. Mew was able to walk through a boundary that she set up, but no one else could, and only objects could. She was to meet Kokichi on the roof. So we're but for Kokichi, the door was locked, so we couldn't get up there, which is highly suspicious, because it's all, you know, Kokichi saying this stuff. You never know when Kokichi's lying or not. Also, I apologize for encoding errors. I apologize for any, all the, video lag. Hopefully this thing soon.
Let's do it!
Alright! Let's go!
Okay.
Yeah! The eight of us got into the elevator. The door shut behind us. And the door can only lock from the outside. And like all those times before, we descended. So that would mean Kaito would have to lock the door. Or something of that sort. But we'll figure that out all at some point. It was dead quiet. The only sound I could hear was the beating of my heart in my ears. My body was trembling. The more I tried to control it, the worse it got. There's no way to get used to it, really. The fear of death. We were all fighting it, trying to be courageous. We all felt as though we were going to our own execution. No, not an execution. A test of our will to survive. Finally, the elevator stopped and the doors opened. And though I couldn't explain it, my body stopped trembling.
Welcome!
Welcome! Go ahead and stand behind any open podium! Move your asses! You don't want to see what you'll do- what I'll do to you if you keep bother waiting!
Huh? Wait, is he back to normal?
Why?
Huh? You're not friend anymore!
You jerks must feel pretty slick, using Minotaur's forgetfulness to befriend him!
He just decided on his own that we were friends!
You bastards!
But I won't let you guys trick Minotaur anymore, cause he's already forgotten! He may have forgotten that he was on Daddy's side, but now he's forgotten that he had forgotten that he was on Daddy's side! Thanks to me, because I smacked the stuffing out of him!
Yeah, how confusing. Well, whatever.
Really?
I can't remember, but one of you guys is the culprit, right? I can't be in the same room as a killer! It's dangerous! I'm gonna go lock myself in my room! Maybe even set up a barricade!
Yeah.
That's another death flag.
Anyway.
Let's get started. The heart-raising excitement as the blanket in the spotless face off.
We went to our podiums, as always. We knew what we had to do. There was no protest left in us. It's already the fourth time. The fourth class trial was about to begin. Okay, we finally get a good look at Mew's corpse. And it doesn't actually really look like her eyes are bloodshot. So it doesn't look like she was actually poisoned. Instead, it kind of looks almost like she was drowned or choked. Miruruma, the ultimate inventor. She may have given us a lot of trouble, but we all miss her. It's a tragedy, after all. She helped me and Kaede with those cameras, gave Kibo extra functions, and in the end, she had done a lot for us. And the culprit that killed her is one of us. I need to discover who that is. In order to survive, I have to find the culprit. And I will fight for it. I will fight with truth and lies in this class trial. Let us save. Here we go. I'm not gonna add any skills. Let's just go right in. Monokuma's so unenergetic.
Before we start, I just want to ask something since there's not a lot of us left. What happens if the votes result in two first places? Huh? You mean like a tie?
Yeah, there are eight of us, so it could happen.
It means they're both the blackens. So long as one of them is correct, it's fine.
Interesting. Why did you bring that up, Suichi?
Daddy, are you sure you should make a decision like that so casually?
Yeah, fine. Whatever. Thanks. Since that's answered, I can start enjoying this life or death game now.
What game? How long are you gonna keep saying that?
Just ignore Kokichi. The rest of us need to work together to find the truth. Got it? We can't die here!
Oh my! Himiko has become so determined!
Filled with determination!
It's true! People really do change!
But now she's lost what made her so unique.
That's none of your business!
We should focus on the class trial. First, we need to clarify...
I like how Muse has three X's. That's funny.
Kaito's the culprit!
What? Say that to my face!
Pretty sure he just did.
While we were all still logged in, Kaito logged out alone, right? You were able to move freely. Doesn't that mean you could have committed the murder?
Don't screw around! There's no way I'm the culprit!
Kaito right. Kaito couldn't have killed Mew.
How long are you gonna keep saying that? Trusted people can still kill, you know. We already saw that a bunch of times. So many times. Since Kaede.
You mean the first killer. So not really a bunch of times, kind of only three times, I guess? The fact that Kaito was the only one logged out is suspicious. But he's not the culprit. He can't be. Time to refute some statements.
Kaito logged out first by himself.
Yes.
You were still logged in there.
Yes.
That's an important right, Kaito?
Ooh, the fact that he said that.
Impossible!
Poison.
Of course it's impossible, because I didn't do it! I mean, we found that bottle of poison on Kokichi's seat, didn't we?
The culprit was trying to pin the blame on me. That diversion was part of your plan, right, Kaito?
Well, Kaito, any last words?
What do you mean, last words?
Let's see. So what do we got? We got Killing Game Simulator. We have the small bottle of poison. And Mew's corpse. I don't know if it's Mew's corpse or small bottle of poison that we'd have to present, but it's one of those two. First, we need to decide if Mew was killed in the virtual, in the real world, or the virtual world. That's where the problem lies.
Kaito logged out.
So our evidence is the Monokuma file, small bottle, Mew's corpse, the Killing Game Simulator, and the hammer.
First, by himself.
And Kaito's account. And Kaito's account said, nothing about that. I say it's Mew's corpse that we had to present at some point.
Kaito culprit?
Not.
The culprit was trying to. Still logged out.
Yes.
You still logged in then.
No, that's true. I'm gonna use Mew's corpse there. Nope, that is wrong.
You saw the label on the poison bottle, right, Tsubichi? Even the smallest amount could kill. That expression of agony on her face definitely looked like the symptoms of poison. Which is why Kaito is the culprit. I sure didn't do it! Tsubichi, back me up here!
Oh no!
Crap!
Kaito logged out first by himself.
So is it the poison?
You still logged in though. That's an poisoner, right, Kaito?
Yes, there we go!
That's wrong!
Mew wasn't killed by poison, and the warning on the label proves it. Drinking the poison would result in subconjunctival hemorrhaging. In other words, your eyes would be bloodshot.
Oh, but Mew's body. That's right. Her eyes weren't bloodshot. She wasn't killed by that poison.
Then what was that poison for?
Probably a diversion. The culprit wanted us to think Mew died by poison. Then, what was her real cause of death?
Mew's real cause of death. The only one I can think of. Toilet paper? No, not likely. All added by Mew setting, avatar error. Crashing noise. What was the question? What was Mew's cause of death? I don't know. Doesn't seem like she would be hammered to death. Not the wall. I doubt it was the avatar error. Oh. If she wasn't poisoned, then what was it? Her body wasn't injured either.
Damn it!
Yep. So it's not the poison, not the corpse.
Was he killed by the Avatar?
Is that really the cause of Mew's death? I don't understand. Judging from the body, maybe the cause of death wasn't located in the real world.
Damn it!
Wow. So it's... the cause of death is Mew's Avatar? Nope. Come on! That was the device. Killing Game Simulator?
This is it!
Seriously? That was it?
Mew's cause of death was the Killing Game Simulator itself. In the virtual world, if your avatar takes fatal damage, your real body dies of shock. That was made clear in the program's text file.
Mew received fatal damage in the virtual world and died from that shock.
In that case, it's fair to say that the cause of death was actually the simulator.
I'm fairly certain in this case, cause of death would be referring to what caused that.
Gonta has question. Where is this virtual world place? What floor is it on?
If you don't understand, then don't say anything.
If Mew was killed in the virtual world, then the next thing we need to figure out is what caused her to incur fatal damage within the virtual world.
So her cause of death in the virtual world is the one that matters.
Yes.
It seems like Gonta is confused. So why don't we review things a bit?
Kyo's, execution thing just kinda has the wavy red all over it. Not sure what it's supposed to be.
So we split into two groups to find the secret of the outside world.
The ones who searched the mansion were me, Shuichi, Smoogie, Gonta, and NPC Kaito.
Hey, who you calling NPC, you ASS?
And the others who searched the chapel were Keyboy, Maki, Himiko, and the late Mew.
How could someone have given her fatal damage in that situation? That's what we gotta think about. Now, let's all work together.
Aww, little Himiko is all grown up. Too bad your chest hasn't grown up, though.
That was uncalled for! Someday, my chest will grow like crazy!
Even without you being here, we still have to make talk about it.
Let's begin then.
The fatal damage that Mew received in the virtual world. Let's pin that down. Alright, so there'll probably have to be a consent about what caused it. Bottle poison, Mew's corpse, sign used as a bridge, hammer,
in the virtual world, Mew fatally injured. Let's focus our efforts on that first.
Whoever did that to Mew was brought right next to her avatar.
Was it?
To be the hammer!
I doubt it.
To beat her with his bare hands.
Are we certain that blunt force was involved? I think strangulation is more likely.
Yeah, I think it was strangulation.
It's possible she was pushed from a great height.
Could she have drowned?
We have to determine the specific cause of death. If I think about the condition of Mew's body, that should yield a clue. And I think, using Mew's corpse, I think she was strangled. Because it looked like she was, like, choking for air.
Was dropped right next to her avatar.
It has to be the hammer!
We're going to beat her with his bare hands.
Are we certain that blunt force was involved? I think strangulation.
I agree!
Yeah, because I don't think she drowned. I think that she was strangled.
His body shows severe trauma and signs of a struggle.
Yeah, she looked like she suffered. Very hard to look at.
Right, and the virtual world is connected to our five senses. If her body experienced pain, she must have been in pain in the virtual world as well. Knowing that, I believe Maki is correct. You were strangled to death.
Yeah, definitely. Drowning and poison are the only methods that can make her look like she suffocated.
I mean, drowning makes them look like they suffocate.
But we already removed the possibility of poison, so it can only be strangulation. Also, when a victim is poisoned, they commonly grab their chest or mouth. But Mew was holding her throat. It's obvious she was trying to protect her windpipe.
Oh, the assassin master gets really chatty when it comes to corpses.
Quiet, Kokichi.
In that case, her exact cause of death is being strangled in the virtual world.
But is strangulation even possible in the virtual world? If the avatars were equally strong, it would be difficult to strangle a resisting victim.
Yeah, if she was just as strong as them, no way they could have strangled her.
Then the culprit would need a tool. There are tons of cases where a weaker person would strangle a stronger person with a rope.
But Mew got rid of all those.
Wow, you know a lot about killing, nerd.
I swear, Maki's probably gonna end up killing him at some point.
I don't remember seeing one.
Then they must have used something else as a rope.
Something for a rope. I have an idea of what that might be. Oh, is it the lattice? I found it during the investigation. Yeah, I guess it would have to be the lattice. Or not. Suichi, something like a rope would be long and you could wind it around stuff. Thanks, Captain Obvious, for that totally unnecessary hint.
I was wrong!
Yay! Alright, let's see, what do we have? Oh! Toilet paper.
This is it!
During the investigation, we found toilet paper outside the mansion.
And because that nothing breaks in that world, it would be just as strong. Is this toilet paper? Why would toilet paper? What would toilet paper be doing here?
I'm guessing that the toilet paper was used to strangle her.
Gonta, no can ignore that!
Oh, we finally get Gonta finally speaks up.
What do you mean, Shuichi? Huh? What's wrong?
What wrong? Shuichi goofing off! Not gentlemanly at all!
Because Gonta doesn't understand computers. Alright, so let's see. I think killing game simulators are,
It's no time late. For nonsense! You know, can use toilet paper in place of rope! Would tear too easy! Even Gonta know that, and Gonta not smart!
Okay, so that's what we have to refute. There's something off about Gonta's statement. I should be careful.
There's no time for nonsense! You know, can use toilet paper in place of rope! Would tear too easy!
Strike!
I'll cut through your words!
The toilet paper wouldn't tear. Because in the virtual world, objects are unbreakable.
You're so dumb, Gonta. You didn't even know that?
If objects can't break in that world, then toilet paper shouldn't be able to tear. And since it couldn't tear, it could be used as a rope.
Gonta not really understand, but... Sorry, Shuichi. Gonta was wrong.
It's okay, Gonta. Don't worry about it.
I like how Gonta only had, like, one phase of his thing.
Killed by toilet paper. It was... a fitting end for her.
A fitting end? I do not fully understand that logic.
But if Mio was killed near the chapel, why was the murder weapon by the mansion?
Maybe the culprit tried to get rid of it to destroy the evidence.
The culprit meant to get rid of the evidence, they did a poor job of it. There was a much better place where they could have destroyed it.
If toilet paper was the murder weapon, then what's the deal with the hammer next door?
Perhaps the culprit prepared a backup weapon, just in case.
No, the culprit didn't bring the hammer.
No? But who else but the culprit would bring a hammer?
Wait, we already know who brought that hammer. It was Mew.
That's it.
So Mew brought us there to kill someone.
Mew was the one who brought the hammer.
You mean bring hammer?
Remember what she told us?
I rewrite the program to delete all dangerous objects could be used as weapons.
Yeah, she did say she deleted any dangerous objects.
If that were true, she wouldn't have missed something like a hammer. Meaning that Mew must have left it on purpose.
On purpose?
But why she do that?
You brought the hammer for sure, but what does he need it for? We need to make that clear. And then this is where we use the truth bullet of Mew and Kokichi's meeting. Yep, there it is.
Let's assume that Mew brought the hammer. What was she planning to do with it?
Maybe use it to break down a wall?
Nope.
Use this for a hammer. Gonta, no! Mew gonna build stuff with hammer!
No.
Probably just brought it to self-defense.
Or she secretly met up with someone. And tried to kill them with it!
You idiot! She was the victim!
I like how we can refute that one. What was Mew planning to do with the hammer? That's still unclear. I need to think back to what she was doing, what her plan was. So she went to secretly meet up with someone. Interesting how it was, Kokichi who said that.
I agree!
Mew was gonna meet up with someone in the virtual world.
Mm-hmm. With me. I was supposed to meet up with Mew on the roof of the mansion.
What? Is that true?
I overheard them talking about it at the chapel.
By the way, Mew asked to meet up with me before we went into the virtual world.
Interesting.
I totally forgot where we were supposed to meet, so good thing Keyboy spied on us.
Wait, so Mew called Kokichi out?
If Mew brought the hammer, I wonder what she was planning to do with it.
Kokichi's already figured it out. She was planning to... kill Kokichi! Confession of love to Kokichi.
She was trying to kill Kokichi.
She was what? Yep, she plotted to meet up with me and then kill me with the hammer. If you want to prove this, you'll need to figure out Mew's plan, okay?
Mew's plan, huh? I'm sure if I analyze the clues we found, I can figure something out. Alright, let's do it! Minigame time! Psych Taxi, let's go! Psyche Taxi. Yes. I got two at once.
Those are the cars. Who tried to kill Kokichi's? You. So sneezy. Alright. So we know who tried to kill Kokichi is Mew. Kokichi figured out Mew's plan, and that's what he was talking with Monokuma about. Look at that secret little meeting thing that he had with him. Oh. Where was Mew trying to kill Kokichi? The roof. Roof of the mansion. Life. Alright. Final question. Why was a bottle of poison on Kokichi's seat? To kill Mew? Let's see, what are options? It would misplace divert attention, hidden evidence. I say to divert attention. Was to kill him and then make it seem like a suicide.
She wanted it to appear as if Kokichi was killed in the real world.
And then I'm save. Something odd. Ah, log in, log out record, I guess.
When could you have put the poison there?
If she did place the poison without us noticing, then she must have logged out at some point.
And then what? Log back in? Kokichi, weren't you in the salon around that time? Did you see her log in or log out at all?
We don't have the cell phone.
Nope, I didn't see that at all. If she hadn't logged in or out, then you couldn't have placed the poison.
Who put poison bottle?
The only person who logged out early was Kaito.
Kaito, your grave just got 10 feet deeper!
No, it wasn't me, guys!
If the poison was is planted evidence, the question is when it was planted. If we determine that, the when, we might also determine the who.
When could you have put the poison there?
If she did place the poison without us...
And the login slash logout record, with the exception of Mew who died before she could log out, everyone only logged in and out once. And there are the following timestamps. Oh! Mew could have, she was the last one to log in!
Edison, then she must have logged out at some point.
And then what? Log back in? Kokichi, weren't you in the salon around that time?
Yep.
Hey there!
If she hadn't logged in, then Mew could
Sorry, I hate to break it to you, man.
That's wrong!
But it wasn't actually possible for Mew to do it.
It was Mew who planted the poison on Kokichi's chair. She had plenty of time to do it. Here, take a look at this.
Is this a record of who went in and out of the virtual world?
That's right. It says that Mew was the last of us to log in.
Yeah, what about it?
If she walked in last, she would have had time to move around in the real world after the previous person walked in.
That's right! She could have placed poison bottle on Kokichi's seat!
This was all part of Mew's plan. She tried to kill me in the virtual world, make us think it happened in the real world, then pin the crime on Kaito.
Yes.
Well, that's not my fault!
Which is why she manually logged you out. Just for that purpose.
Yeah.
So she did that to me?
Yes, I'm positive of that. Mew used a method only she could use to log Kaito out manually.
How did Mew log Kaito out? It was the cell phone.
This is it!
It was the cell phone found by Mew's avatar. That cell phone worked the same way as the phone in the salon. It logs users in and out. I verified this myself when I spoke Kaito's name into it.
Kaito Momota. He logged out, just as I thought.
I see. With that cell phone, she could force anyone to log out at any time.
But Mew never mentioned a cell phone, right?
That's what Shuichi referred to when he mentioned a method only she could use. She kept the cell phone a secret on purpose, so she could use it for the murder.
So, she really was planning a murder.
And she tried to set me up.
Oof.
Well, I knew that from the start.
Then why did you say I was the culprit?
Because I wanted to get it through your thick skull. People you trust and defend will ultimately betray you. This is a game of suspicion.
Thank you for that lesson in morality.
Well, I think your ideals should stay the same. Because phonies like you are what make the game more interesting. Don't you agree, Monokuma?
Do I? I don't know about that.
Ugh. Kokichi's become more Monokuma than Monokuma is.
Huh? Wait. What were we talking about?
I wonder when Daddy's gonna get his motivation back.
Yeah! If Father keeps slacking off, all the work is gonna get forced onto Mommy.
Huh?
Mommy? My head! I feel like I'm about to remember something, but I can't.
Come on, remember! Join our side!
The Frog Monotaro! Call yourself together!
Anywho, it's a blessing in disguise that Mew died and not me.
What you mean?
because she wouldn't have said anything about what really happened in the virtual world. You guys would have had a way harder time finding the culprit, you know. She would have been able to lie about the virtual world settings as much as she wanted.
She's not wrong there.
And you'd never know that the murder actually took place in the virtual world.
So that's why she decided to attempt a murder, because she had total control.
And the reason Mew was so insistent with going to the virtual world was...
You guys are only bitching because you haven't been to the virtual world yet. But once you go, you'll understand. Seriously, it's so fucking awesome. I know you guys will love it. And then you're gonna fall in love with me for showing it to you guys. So, let's just dive right in, okay? We'll do it together. Ew, why do you have to be the killer?
She was insistent we go there so she could kill us. What a shady person.
Why do you have to be an attempted murderer?
I was sad that she was gone, but now I don't know what to think.
Nice! Backstabbed by a trusted friend. See? That's an ideal fun situation! Now we can start a real class trial!
Hey, Kokichi sort of sound like Monokuma.
Yeah?
Really? I don't sound anything like him.
No, you're just like Monokuma. Both of you are cowards. You never speak the truth or show your true face.
Wait, coward? You say some interesting things sometimes, Kaito.
Interesting.
Smiling, putting on a mask, never saying what you really think. That kind of cowardice is just like Monokuma!
Daddy, you're going to be a coward! Aren't you going to do something?
Yeah, I just got to do my signature laugh, right? There, I did it.
Jeez.
He's completely lost his drive! Like a one-hit wonder who clings to their former fame!
My head!
Listen up, Kokichi! To hell with this game of suspicion crap! I will never be okay with it! I'm just gonna believe in everyone! Instead of suspecting my friends, I'm gonna find the truth by believing in them!
Well, if you think you can win this game like that... Then sure, be my guest.
Of course I can. I don't need your permission.
How long are you guys going to argue? Let's hurry this up and continue. If we don't find the culprit, then we'll all die, you know that? I'm sorry.
Not really any clear clue about who could be the culprit.
If we are going to begin searching for the culprit, let's start with Kokichi's story.
Huh? My story?
You were meeting with Mew, but she ended up as the victim. So it's only natural for us to think you're the killer, right?
Here's my answer. I never met up with Mew!
You didn't?
I tried to go to the roof to meet up with her, but the door was locked.
But isn't lockpicking your specialty? You should have been able to open it easy.
First of all, you kind of need a lock picking. You kind of need the stuff to pick a lock. Second, the lock was on the outside.
I couldn't pick locks with my avatar body. I didn't have the tools for it either. Also, I never went to the roof. Not even for the meeting.
I remember. You and Gota went off together when we first started looking. But was the door to the roof actually locked? When I was on the roof before logging out, the door wasn't locked.
Huh? How should I know?
Then who locks the door to the roof?
I already told you! How should I know?
When I went to the roof, it wasn't locked. So you gotta be lying.
What good would it be if I lied? I don't wanna die either, you know?
I mean, if you're the black end, then it makes sense you would lie.
Lying would do you a lot of good if you're the culprit.
Oh, I see. I didn't realize that.
What
What kind of response is that? That's suspicious as hell!
Wait, there's no point in arguing about that now. The truth will come out eventually. Before we get to that, we need to discover the truth behind Mew's death.
Truth?
There were mysterious circumstances surrounding her death. We need to make sense of those first.
Wow, Shuichi, you know your way around this game. Yes, keep up the hard work. The fate of our lives rests in your hands.
Why are you encouraging me?
So, what is this strange circumstance? Kokichi claims it was Mew who chose the meeting place. But I'm wondering how she got from the chapel to the mansion's roof.
I see. Mew sent the bridge connecting the mansion and chapel into the river herself.
Whoops! My hand slipped!
If that's the case, then Mew might not have even gone to the roof.
Oh? So she stood me up? Very rude to break a promise.
It's true. First we need to determine if Mew was actually there or not. Did she go? Or was she never on the roof at all? I guess Samugi's account.
Mew was waiting for me to arrive. I'm sure she was waiting on the rooftop of the mansion.
No. Mew should have been at the chapel.
Should have been.
Look at where her avatar fell. He's right next to the chapel.
Yeah, that's true.
How would she have gotten to the mansion? There was no bridge over the river.
A bridge would be the only way to get across.
Oh, I think that's where we have to,
with Kokichi.
Deny that.
She stood me up!
At first glance, it seems as if it's impossible for Mew to go to the mansion. But there has to be some evidence that such was possible.
Mew was waiting for me to arrive.
I'm sure
she was waiting on the rooftop of the mansion.
No. Mew should have been at the chapel.
I guess Smoogie's account.
Look at where her avatar fell.
What do we shoot? Yes, that's true. No, that's not.
He's waiting for me.
Yes. Should have been, but she wasn't.
That's wrong!
Mew must have gone to the mansion. We have a witness.
Yeah. When I was searching the dining room, I saw Mew pass by the window.
Then why didn't you say so sooner?
Sorry. I thought I was just mistaken at first. Since there was no way she could have come to the mansion. But I guess I wasn't mistaken after all. That was definitely Mew.
Then, how did she get to the mansion from the chapel?
Must have been some special method only Mew knew, like with that cell phone.
There's no doubt about that. That's why she dropped the bridge. If a murder occurred when it was impossible to cross the river, she wouldn't be implicated.
Yeah?
She used a secret method to move from the chapel to the mansion for the murder.
Yes, she did.
She dropped the bridge to make a huge scene, just to let everyone know it's no longer there.
So, what secret method did she use?
Walking!
It won't be that easy to figure out. It's called a secret method for a reason.
No worries, guys. As long as we leave it to Shuichi, everything will be A-okay.
What?
What are you saying? We can't just rely on Shuichi all the time. This class file's for all of us. We're here to solve this together.
You would just slow down, Shuichi.
Shut up!
I don't have time to deal with Kokichi. Right now I have to focus on the case. I'm positive that Mew used some kind of special method to get to the mansion. Okay, I just have to figure out what it was. Now let's see, what are our truth bullets?
The way across the
across it.
Oh, it would be the wall added by you.
Bridge, besides that cyborg maybe.
Nope.
Or instead of bridge, you use some kind of vehicle to go over.
Nope.
Or maybe she teleported with magic.
Actually, that might be what we have to
see. Warp zone.
Maybe there's a place you could cross without a bridge.
Oh.
A hidden route that only you could use to get across.
Yes.
Oh. How else will she use that to change places?
You guys are weird.
For me, I'm just
pulling your legs.
Cross it
over. Oh. I should have read that, but I know what it is.
Instead of
bridge. Maybe some kind of vehicle to go over.
So she didn't teleport.
Warp zone.
There's a place you could
cross without a bridge.
A hidden route that only you could use to get across.
Right, right there.
I agree.
That's it, Kibo. There was a hidden route only you could use.
Was that really?
Mew modified the program to add a special wall to the world. The wall stretches along the y-axis, but we found two such walls in the virtual world. It's unclear whether Mew had the wall by the mansion or the wall near the chapel. We do know that that wall was set so that only objects could pass through.
Don't be naive, Shuichi!
Oh? Oh, hello, Kaito.
Mm-hmm. What is it, Kaito?
Jeez, you set up a weird wall like that? That is suspicious, but it's got nothing to do with what we were talking about.
Nothing to do with it?
Huh, you don't even realize your mistake? You're losing your edge.
Kaito!
Well, my sidekick's mistakes are my mistakes. I'll make it right.
Well, time to prove Kaito wrong. Let's see. So where is Mew's avatar? There we go.
What we gotta figure out is how Mew got from the chapel to the mansion, right?
Yes.
Why waste time talking about the impossible? It's pointless.
Sorry, it's not impossible.
We gotta take a whole new approach here.
We are taking a new approach.
No, wait just a second. It's not actually impossible at all.
But you just said so, didn't you? That wall Mew set up only lets non-human objects go through it.
Yes?
Humans aren't able to pass through. So Mew obviously wouldn't be able to go through that wall. She's not just an object after all.
Oh! Okay, so that's what I have to cut.
Let's go through this one more time.
There's no doubt that Mew was able to pass through that wall. We need to give some kind of proof for that.
But you just said so, didn't you? That wall Mew set up.
Yes.
Only lets non-human objects go through it.
Yes.
Humans aren't able to pass through.
Yes.
So Mew obviously wouldn't be able to go through that wall. She's not just an object after all.
Gotcha!
I'll cut through your words.
Nice of me!
The wall wasn't the only thing that Mew changed. She also changed her avatar settings from human to object.
From human to object?
Which means the virtual world treated her avatar as an object. She could have passed through a wall that only non-humans could go through.
Is that right?
Yes, yes it is.
Get ahead of yourself, Kaito. We need to listen to everything Shuichi says.
I already told you. The more you try, the more you cause us trouble.
It's so totally lame that your own sidekick is dissing you!
Kokichi, enough! I wasn't arguing with him. I was just explaining.
I don't care. That doesn't bother me at all. It just means even I make mistakes. Don't worry about it, Shuichi.
We're not worried about it.
Okay.
It's pretty funny seeing Kaito try to act all tough like this.
Kokichi, please refrain from making such irrelevant and irrational remarks.
So,
If Mew messed with the program and made a wall only she could go through, then her secret route was through that wall? That's it, right? Like using a glitch in a game to walk outside the map. I bet Mew had a hidden passage like that in the back of the chapel.
Not quite.
But even if she could walk through walls, was there really a hidden passage? Because Mew said...
No, you're not trapped in here. Beyond that wall is the end of the world. Literally. Past that wall, nothing exists. Everything ends there.
She probably lied. There would be no point in going if there was nothing on the other side.
You lied. I wonder what the truth is.
There's no way to find out now.
That cum-soaked urinal cake was totally lying about there being nothing past the wall. She lived a life of pride, vulgarity, and secrets. Lying would be a piece of cake for her.
Kichi, you no have to go that far.
Spoken like, one of their own.
Stop it! Don't badmouth mommy!
Always remembering!
Listen to you, talking about mommy. She was a terrible lying whore. But mommy wasn't lying. There was no hidden road to that virtual world.
There wasn't, huh?
Hey! You can't tell if it's an important hint!
Oh! If you see that hint is important, then I guess it must be true.
Gotcha!
Jeez. You hear you.
Was Kokichi saying all that stuff about Mew to get the cubs to reveal something? I guess I should thank him, but I have no idea why he does things sometimes.
So now that we know there's no hidden route, why did she manipulate the program? If there's actually nothing past the wall, then that setting was meaningless.
You wouldn't have done something meaningless. She would have had a plan.
Yes. You definitely wanted to be able to go through that wall for a reason. We aren't sure why yet, but once we solve the mystery of the virtual world...
Mystery of virtual world?
Easy, Gonta. Don't strain your brain too much.
Virtual world. If we can determine why, we will also determine what Mew was up to. We'll know why she wanted to pass through the wall.
Alright, let's clear up those strange occurrences.
Yeah, Gonta will help, even though Gonta not know what you're talking about.
Speaking of strange occurrences, I'm just plain worried about that one thing. Remember? That thing that made us notice all the strange occurrences?
Stop speaking in riddles, woman! The events that led us there. The loud noise?
This is it!
You mean the loud sound that you and I heard in the kitchen?
Ah!
What? What was that sound?
It sounds as if something was struck very hard. It came from outside, but...
You all heard that sound too?
Yes, in the mansion's kitchen.
But that sound occurred near the chapel. How could you hear it all the way at the mansion?
First off, sound can't go past the map loading point. Did that sound really come from the chapel?
Yes, it did, actually.
The sound was something hitting the chapel wall. It was real loud.
So the culprit was on the roof, and then killed Muse by strangling her with the toilet paper, dropped that off the side of the roof, wrapped her up in the lattice or something like that, and launched her off the mansion roof and into the chapel wall.
And we definitely heard it. We heard Kibo's voice as well.
For now, let's go outside and check.
Oh no!
What?
That was That was Kibo's voice, right? I think I heard him outside. He sounded close.
You heard my voice too?
What? That is pretty strange.
Exactly. That has to be some kind of clue to the mystery of the virtual world.
Okay. Well, let's check the answers later and try to find all the other clues first. There was another mysterious phenomenon in the virtual world, wasn't there?
Kokichi talked like he noticed something. Pretending not to know?
Even Gonta is suspicious of me? I always thought you would be the one to trust me!
I'm actually most suspicious of Kokichi.
Sorry, Gonta did not mean it like that.
There's no need to apologize to him. He's probably just lying again.
What was the other strange occurrence? Did you see it, Shuichi?
Because the other three were at the chapel and they actually couldn't get through. I was with Tsumugi. The only people unaccounted for were Kaito, Kokichi, and Gonta. And Kaito was forcibly logged out before Mew was killed due to the time of death. The only two are Gonta and Kokichi. And I don't think that Gonta would have killed her. Another mysterious phenomenon. Something that shouldn't be possible, like Mew in the mansion or that loud noise. I need to remember everything else that happened in there. My mind. I know what it is too, it's the signboard. Ooh. That's interesting. Oh. Oh, perfect. I found it. This. Yep, gotta get rid of these. Now let's do this. And let's... Oh, come on. Oh, come on! There we go!
I see it!
There was a signboard somewhere over here.
What you were using as a bridge was odd to me. Odd how? We mentioned it before, but Mew dropped the sign in the river.
Whoops, my hand slipped.
We found it later, but there was something unnatural about it.
Finding the sign was definitely weird. I'm most confused about how the sign got there. I should remember exactly what happened with that sign. Alright, here we go. A second psych taxi? Sheesh! This is the first time we've had to do two of them. Whoa! Okay, now the letters move. Okay, so now I gotta factor in the fact that the letters are gonna move. This would be interesting. Ah! What is... Also, my controls are just feeling a little weird right now. At which point was the sign swept away? That would be... the river. Oh, mansion side. Nope! Oh! Oh, I straight up just, like, smashed that person. So that was phase 1 of 4. Interesting, we got 4 of them this time that we have to do. I like how it's pictures of you.
It's at the wall, right? The end of the river would be the wall. Chapel side. Let me guess, the next question, where does the chapel, where does the river start? Okay, now these ones aren't moving. Okay, now that I spoke too soon. So now it's a mix of moving and not moving. Just missed a bunch of letters, though. There was a sign found after it was swept away. It was found on the mansion side. Pictures of Smoogie this time. Interesting. So I guess it just randomly picks about what the pictures are. Compared to the river's current, which way did this signboard float? The other direction. It floated with the current. Nope, that's the wrong, that was the wrong one. That is the wrong one, because in actuality it went with the current, but nope, perceived it went against it.
It appeared as though the sign was carried against the river's current. We all saw Mew drop the sign and watched the river carry it downstream. And the river was wide there. The sign should have traveled downriver toward the chapel, correct? It should have hit the wall on the far side of the chapel and stopped there. That's not where we found it. We found it near the mansion, nestled in some rocks.
The signboard should have been near the chapel, but we found it on the other side.
Hold up! Didn't you stay on the chapel side? She probably grabbed the signboard from the chapel wall to cross the river. Then left it on the boulders near the mansion so she could get back.
Why would she leave the signboard where it could get swept away and leave her stranded?
Also, this has nothing to do with walking through the wall, right? We're getting off topic. We're so close to the truth. We just have to connect the how and what.
It's so painfully obvious.
All the mysterious things that happened have to connect with each other somehow.
Connect how?
A wall only objects can pass through. Sounds that shouldn't be heard. A songboard going against the river current. How are they all connected?
I don't know, But Shuichi should know, right?
Please don't make me do another psych taxi.
What?
Psyche taxi.
We would be in a lot of trouble if you didn't. The only one who can solve this mystery and save us all is you.
So, how are they connected? Do you know Shuichi?
Ah, well, what we know so far is that the unnatural way the sign was carried is possibly related to the wall.
What's the question? What clue is related to the unnatural way the signboard was carried on the river? Clue's related? The map, I guess? Map of the world? There's something we knew about, and that's throwing us off. You're saying we're being thrown off, but you seem pretty calm.
Damn it!
Nope, that's not it. So let's see, what clue was related to the unnatural way the signboard was carried on the river? All added by Mew.
This is it!
Oh.
It might have to do with a wall that only objects can pass through. The sign should have stopped at the wall on the other side of the chapel. But if that wall happened to be the one that Mew set to allow objects through...
I see. It's a wall only non-humans can pass through. That means the signboard can pass through the wall, right?
Even if it could pass through the chapel wall, how did it end up by the mansion?
The only way it could do that is if the wall was a warp zone. But it's not, right?
That's right. That's the real issue here. How could the signboard pass through the wall but end up on the mansion side? What would explain that?
Leave it to me, Shuichi. I, your partner, will give you hints in times of trouble.
What?
This is the virtual world. We should throw away all of our common sense, okay?
Huh? The hell does that even mean?
Kokichi might be onto something there. We need to forget about what we know and just think about it. How did the signboard pass through the wall downstream and end up upstream? Putting common sense aside and focusing on the flow of the river, how did the signboard pass through? Downstream and upstream connect. Thank you. Someone realized it.
What if both ends of the river were connected?
Huh? Both ends of river connected?
Exactly. To put it another way, the river isn't cut off at the wall near the chapel. It's all part of one big loop. The upstream part of the river is connected to it.
What? What are you talking about? Both ends of the river can't...
Again, throw out all common sense from your head. We're talking about the virtual world.
Then what about the wall? There was only one wall that could be passed through.
Yeah, the same wall!
Right. Even if the river's connected, and it goes through the chapel wall, it wouldn't have been able to go through the mansion wall, too.
I still can't believe you people have to argue this so hard. Wait, in that case...
I got it. I know why you only set up one wall.
What are you talking about now?
The reason she only set up one wall is because the chapel and mansion walls... They're the same wall.
That's it.
The walls by the chapel and the mansion aren't separate. They're the same wall. The same wall. It's not just the river. The walls themselves are connected. Don't think of it as two separate walls, but a single wall parallel to the y-axis. That single wall divides the entire virtual world. The idea is, you pass through the wall by the chapel and come out by the mansion.
Everything is starting to connect. See, didn't I tell you? Everything is connected.
Damn it, Kokichi! Just tell us!
It's okay. More importantly, this is the final stretch! If both the river and wall are connected, then you can find the secret. Shuichi, you already know the secret behind the virtual world, right?
Yeah, they're kind of connected. The secret, huh? Yes, I suppose we should clear that up. We need to solve the mystery of the virtual world. Hangman's Gambit time. Let's see. So question. What is a unique feature of the virtual world? Crap. It wasn't L, what was it? Damn, I made too many mistakes. Do they think I did it?
Done debating already?
No.
Well, the next part's mandatory, so let's get this over with. It's voting time!
Is this really?
No, no it's not.
We can't let it end here.
So the question is, what's a unique feature about F, W, R, L, D, world loops? That's what it is. Where's the P? And I see this.
I see now.
Yes, that's it. The virtual world is a loop. Loop.
Just like in old games, right? Like, for example...
Pac-Man?
When a character goes off the left side of the screen and reappears on the right.
Yes, exactly. The edges of the virtual world are linked together in a continuous loop.
The virtual world... Oops.
What in the world?
If that's true, it would explain the way the cyborg was swept away. It vanished into the wall downstream of the river, came out of that same wall upstream,
yep, and just
and floated with the current until it got caught on the rocks.
What was the world like before I knew out of the wall?
Actually, there wasn't a wall on the y-axis at all, and the x-axis was set to loop.
Are you serious? Even if it is a computer program, isn't that too crazy?
Not really.
A looping world. That's more ordinary than even magic.
It's not that hard, people. It's called a circle. It's called a cylinder.
But at least it's not a boring answer. It also explains all the things that happened.
Huh? It doesn't explain everything, does it?
Yes, it does.
Because we still don't know why we heard that one sound or Kibo's voice.
Yeah, sound doesn't go past the map loading point.
It didn't go through the map loading point!
Actually, if we know that the world is a loop, we can explain that as well. Huh? Really? Yes, But first we need to be clear where the loop starts.
Where the loop starts? Doesn't it loop at the walls next to the mansion and chapel?
Not necessarily. If we heard a noise at the chapel from inside the mansion, then the loop...
Where's the looping point? Right... there?
There! The map loading point was where the virtual world looped. We thought the loading point was in the middle of the map. But the loading point was actually at the edges.
Yes!
But the wall you created wasn't at the edges of the world, but rather... the wall was at the center of the world.
I see. So the mansion and chapel were near each other, with a wall between them. And any sounds emitted near the chapel would also reach the mansion. The wall only allows non-humans to pass through, so sound should be able to pass through easily.
That's right! That's how the virtual world works!
Impressive, Shuichi!
That was an impressive laugh.
For you to get this far! Yes! Yes! You are useful indeed!
For you to get this far? What are you, some villain pulling the strings?
I actually think so.
Nope. Mew pulled the strings here, not me. Remember? Mew also set this trap. It all began when Mew showed us the map. Because of the map, we mistakenly thought the loading point was at the center, which in turn made the mansion and chapel seem farther away from each other.
But the structure of the world wasn't actually like that. There was a wall along the y-axis, and the x-axis came around in a loop.
By putting that wall in the center of that world, she cut off the loop.
So ever since Mew showed us that map, we were caught in her trap. But we solved this mystery thanks to Shuichi.
Yeah! If Shuichi wasn't here, then we never would have solved this mystery!
That's right! Good work, Shuichi!
Thanks, Shuichi! You saved us!
You're welcome.
Just because we found out the virtual world's secret doesn't mean we can take it easy yet. Actually, this culprit hunt just got to the exciting part.
The actual part where we actually find out who the culprit is.
Even if we know all the tricks, it's pretty meaningless if we don't find the culprit. That's how a class trial works, after all!
Keiichi talking like Monokuma again.
No matter what you say, I'm not gonna believe your lies. I'm gonna believe in everyone. That's how I'm gonna reach the truth.
I can't wait to see what happens next!
Sound like you're planning something. What is Kokichi's plan here? He's definitely prodding at Kaido on purpose. Well, there's no time for distractions like him. What we have to do is find the culprit who killed Mew. It doesn't matter how many little mysteries we solve, if we can't find the culprit, it would all be for nothing. But I still don't know who for sure... I don't know for sure who it could be. Who used Mew's own plan against her to kill her? Who killed Mew? Hey! Perfect timing. Let's save the game! And we will figure out who actually killed Mew. Next time, because we are out of time. Thank you everybody so much for watching. We managed to figure out the secret of the virtual world. But we still don't have any clues about who actually killed her, we know it had to be somebody on the mansion side, and the only two people that could be are Kaita, only two people it could be are Kokichi and Gonta. They're the only two people who it could possibly be. Because me and Tsumugi were together. Kaita was forcibly logged out, and all the others were actually stuck at the chapel. So it's only those two who possibly could have killed her. And because Gonta was outside, I really think it was Kokichi who did it. I think it was Kokichi. Though it is possible that maybe Tsumugi, killed her, but I highly doubt that she would have been able to. I highly doubt that she would have. But we'll find out more on Tuesday, because I'm not streaming on the weekends or Mondays. So, thank you everybody so much for watching, and to quote the ultimate artist, Angie, bye-bye!